Joining us to discuss what to do with stocks during all of this trade tension, Savita Subramanian, head of U.S. equity strategy at Bank of America Merrill Lynch, and Brian Levitt, senior investment strategist at Oppenheimer Fund. So, Savita, when your clients call and say another $200 billion worth of Chinese imports are going to be taxed, this is an escalation, what do we do? What do you say?
Right. Well, you know, I think that there are some playbooks that might not work this time. So I think the idea that you want to hide out in small caps is not necessarily the way to go. So if you think about it, a lot of smaller companies are feeders into these big multinationals that are more likely to be hurt. So I think that the knee-jerk reaction is buy small caps because they're more insulated, but they might not be. You know, I think that the outcome is it's obviously, you know, getting worse rather than getting better. You know, I think that we could expect to see more volatility through the summer. Where I would go is I would look for pockets of the market that are cheap and are not necessarily susceptible to trade friction. For example, financials to me looks like an undervalued sector that's traded cheaply with the yield curve, not necessarily exposed to trade friction, and a lot of high quality companies at really beaten down multiples. Within industrials, you know, this has been a sector that has been painful for the last month or two, but I do think that there are pockets that might not be as negatively impacted by trade risk as price action would indicate. But I do think that there are pockets of the market today, like higher quality areas, that are not as necessarily negatively affected by trade as what's priced in at this point.
So interesting. David Kostin of Goldman Sachs told us the same thing this morning. Financials are insulated, and yet financials have been underperformers, and they really haven't gotten a boost.
Yes.
In fact, they've sold off pretty hard when you have trade worries and more macro concerns that impact the bond market.
Exactly. So I think the market's getting that wrong. I mean, I think that what's interesting to me is that financials have traded with like almost a, you know, 100% correlation with the yield curve, when the truth is if the Fed is hiking and if these companies are cash rich, they have healthy balance sheets, that right there is a positive. You know, I think that financials might actually be the new high quality sector. And I feel like I'm going to be struck down for saying this, having lived through the financial crisis. But the sector today is very different from what it looked like in 2007, 2008, when it was overlevered, you know, was paying maxed out dividend yield, maxed out cash return. Today, it's just starting to ramp up and leverage is, you know, all but, you know, reduced to the lowest levels I've seen in my career. I think it's an underappreciated quality sector.
Brian, what about you? Where do you hide out? Do you think small caps are a safe area because they have less exposure, for instance, to overseas earnings? Or like Savita, do you pick other places in the market?
Well, I think you want to continue to look for growth across market capitalization in the United States. So the administration to this point is really, they've really signaled what they wanted to do, and we've gotten there now. So there was this concern, do we get 10% tariffs on another $200 billion, and here it is, just like the administration seemed to suggest they would do. The good news, I think, for investors is that the 10-year rate has been generally stable in here. The dollar has been reasonably stable the last couple of days. So I don't think the market is completely stunned by this. Look, we can go down the, you know, what if this escalates significantly? If it does, you want to be more domestically focused, and I think the dollar will strengthen in that environment. But for investors who are thinking long term and can see through some of this noise, for us, this is a cycle that's still doing reasonably well. The tariffs will slow down economic growth some. To me, that's still a growth in a slow growth world environment where you can find it. And I suspect we'll continue to see things like technology, small, mid, and large, continue to be the outperformers.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.